Of sequels, then Broadway is a land of revivals, and suddenly Seymour, the next one coming back, is Little Shop of Horrors.
How do you feel bringing this play back to Broadway?
Jazzed. Very, very psyched. I love this material. I love this music. I love the story. I love the craftsmanship that Howard Ashman and Alan Menken apply to this material, to the Roger Corman source material. It's the kind of show I love. Great rock and roll music, really clever, incisive lyrics, and a story that's just as timely today as it was back in 82, certainly when they put it together, you know. Be careful what you wish for.
That's legendary director Jerry Zaks, who's no stranger to directing some of the country's most beloved musicals.
I went through a similar thing with Guys and Dolls. You know, I had everybody in the city coming up to me and saying, it's my favorite musical, it's my favorite musical, which translates into don't mess it up. I'm just eager, so just the usual pressures of being ready for opening night in October.
And speaking of opening,
Seymour.
I think you better listen to him, Seymour. Little Shop is the story of Seymour Crowborn, a florist who makes a pact with a man-eating plant in order to win the heart of the adorable Audrey. And played by Broadway star Kerry Butler, really, who could blame him?
No, we're just friends.
Audrey, the dream character for any musical actress?
I think so. That's what I hear from everyone who finds out that you're playing it. They're like, oh my gosh, you're Audrey!
And oh my gosh, that's Disney's music guru, Alan Menken, who co-wrote Little Shop based on a 1960s Roger Corman film with the late Howard Ashman in 1981.
This is the Motherlode. This was Howard's and my first success. We had one musical prior to this, God Bless You, Mr. Rosewater. But this was our baby. It was probably the peak experience of my career.
Actor Hunter Foster is coming off the peak experience of his own career, having earned rave reviews for his star turn in the hit Broadway musical, Urinetown.
Urinetown was one of the best experiences of my life, and it changed, you know, it was just great. I can't believe so many people liked it and embraced it and still go see it after 2.5 years.
Was Seymour or something in the back of your mind?
Yes, it was something I always wanted to do, and I've auditioned for it a lot, for like regional theaters like that. I've never gotten the part.
And how incredible is it? Now you're in the show.
Yeah, so it's kind of, it's crazy that way.
What did you think when you heard it was coming back to Broadway?
Well, I thought, you know, that it would be great because it's such a good show. And, you know, I was doing history at the time, so I was like, oh, that'll be fun. We'll have, you know, a fun show across the street from us. And the shows are sort of similar in that they're both set in the 60s, and it's really fun music, and they both have a strong message.
And if opening this rehearsal to the media sends any message at all, it's that Little Shop of Horrors is bound to be anything but little.
See?